Hello students, in the last lecture we have discussed about the azeotropic mixtures. Okay, so before that simply we can say that broadly we have discussed about the vapor pressure of the liquids in liquids, and in that again the types of solutions based on the Raoult's law. Okay, ideal and non-ideal solutions, and later that we have seen an important one important topic, that was the azeotropic mixture. Okay, and now in this class now I am going to discuss about the vapor pressure of solids liquid solutions, solid liquid solution, or simply you can say that solid in liquid solution. Okay, so that means solid is a solute and a liquid is a solvent. Liquid is a solvent. Okay, and simply you know that what is the vapor pressure. Already you know that the vapor, the pressure exerted by the vapor on the surface of the solution, you can call it as a vapor pressure. Okay, and now here the vapor pressure, how the vapor pressure can change. Okay, how the vapor pressure can change when you added the solute as a solids, when you added the solid into the solvent. Okay, so again just I'll go back to the previous solutions in solutions, liquids in liquid, sorry, liquids in liquids. Okay, so the vapor pressure of liquid in liquid, once again I am telling, don't be bored. Okay, so you take a liquid A. Okay, and you will take the liquid B. Okay, so here it is, I am taking in the red pen, liquid B. Okay, later that what we will do, generally we will mix this liquid A and liquid B and we will make a solution. We will make a solution. Okay. And in that some liquid A can be there, blue, and some liquid B can be there. Some liquid B can be there. Okay. Right. And you know that after mixing this, you call it as a solution. This you can call it as a and solution. And in that A is there and B is also there. Okay, A is there and B is also there. Okay, and after some time what will happen, after some time what will happen, this solution can be vaporized and gives some vapors. Okay, and this blue one is corresponding to the A and also gives some vapors of B, also gives some vapors of B. Okay, right. Okay, so that means in this also some B vapors there. These are the vapor phase and this is the liquid phase. Okay, this is the down one is the liquid phase and the above one is the vapor phase. Okay, so and according to the Raoult's law, what he said is that according to the Raoult's law, here the vapor pressure of the A is directly proportional to the mole fraction, the fraction present in the solution. Okay, that is nothing but XA into P naught A into P naught A. Okay, and for the B, the PB, the vapor pressure of the B component is equal to the fraction of B into the pures, the vapor pressure in the pure state. Okay, here is a P naught B and here it is a P naught A. Okay, the vapor pressure. Okay, and in the vapor phase, here also we have discussed the vapor phase is equal, the vapor pressure is equal to YA into P total and PB is equal to YB into P total. So these are all the things we have discussed in the liquid in liquid. Okay, and here what I am going to see is that meeru rendu liquid ni combine chesinappudu em avutundi, and those two liquids, they started the vaporization. After some time what will happen, they both can vaporize and give the corresponding mixture, corresponding a fraction or mixture in the vapor state. Okay, but now come to here, solid in liquid. Okay, so now you have a liquid. So that is a liquid, you assume it as a. Okay, now you have a some solid. Okay, so now what you are do, generally the vapors, the liquids, this is a liquid, can vaporize and gives its correspond shows some vapor pressure. It shows some vapor pressure. Why? Because generally the liquids are volatile in nature. The liquids can be volatile so that they can vaporize and give the vapor pressure. And this corresponding vapor pressure, that is equal to is P naught A. This is the vapor pressure of the A. Okay. And come to here, this is the solid. Does that solid shows any vapor pressure? No, right? Because the solids are non-volatile. The solids are non-volatile so that they cannot evaporate. They cannot give any vapors. They cannot give any vapor so that there is no vapor pressure for this. So that no vapor pressure. No vapor pressure. Okay. But when you mix together, so what will be there? This is the liquid. This is the liquid. This is the liquid. And what about the solid? I am taking in the red pen. These you assume it as a solid particles. Solid particles ila untai anukundam. Okay. Now tell me that it is a solution, and in this solution, liquid A is there, plus there is some solid. Okay, there is some solid. Okay, so this is a solute and this is a solvent, right? And in this solution, after some times, what can vaporize? What can convert into the vapor? Does that solute, the solid, vaporize? No, it cannot vaporize. What can vaporize? Only the liquid A. Only the liquid A can be vaporized. Liquid A can be vaporized. But here, in the liquid case, both liquids can vaporize. And here is also there is some composition. But here, it is only one vapor. It is only one solution. Only one liquid, that liquid A can be vaporized. Okay. So that means here the vapor pressure, here the vapor pressure, that depends only on the A. Only on the A. Is it true? Yes, obviously. It is only depends on the A. That means PA is equal to XA into P naught A. XA into P naught A. XA into P naught A. Okay. But what can happen when you added the solids? When you add the solids is that generally here this is the vapor pressure, pure vapor pressure in the pure state. Okay. When you added the solids, the vapor pressure of this liquid, what will happen? The vapor pressure of this liquid decreases. So earlier ikkada vapor pressure 10 undi anukondi, meeru solid add chesin tarvata that vapor pressure is equal something is a 5. 5 at 10 atma, you assume it as a 5 atma. Why it is decreasing? When you added the solid particles, why the vapor pressure is decreasing? Okay, that we can see. Okay, now are you clear here? You may be right. Right, okay. So now you see here the important point. When non-volatile solute added to the pure solvent, the vapor pressure of the solution is decreases or less than the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, than the pure solvent. Why? Okay, you see here it is a pure solvent. Here is a pure solvent. Okay, and it has a very good vapor pressure. And when you added some solute or solid, so what is the solute here? Is a red color. Okay, these are the red colors. Okay, these are the red colors. Okay, you assume here is also. Okay, so you see here there is a 1 mole of solvent is there. For that they added 1 mole of solute, 1 mole of solute, and form some solution. Okay, and when you added that solute, solid solute, the vapor pressure is decreasing. The vapor pressure is decreasing. Why it is decreasing? Why it is decreasing is that very simple. The best example at your home is that you take some water, and you boil that one. You know that. So what is the vapor pressure? And generally it boils at the 100 degrees centigrade, 100 degrees centigrade, and the vapor, it also has some vapor pressure. Okay, but when you added some salt to that, what will happen? The vapor pressure. Generally, when you added some salt to that, or some sugar, or some glucose, or anything solid, solute, the vapor pressure decreases. The vapor pressure decreases. Okay. So why it can decreases is that very simple. In a pure liquid, the entire surface is occupied by the molecules of a liquid only. Right? Okay. You see here. The surface, generally before going to that, how the a liquid convert into the vapor? Obviously, sir, when you heat it, the liquid convert into the vapor. Kani vapor ki velle mundu, which molecules, from where it can escape, from where it can escape. Okay, so this is also very, very important. Okay, solution undila, the intlo, suppose these are some water molecule. You assume that these are the water molecules and this is the closed vessel, and you are heating downside. You are heating, and while heating, what will happen? After some time, some water molecules will escape from this liquid phase to the vapor phase, right? Okay. So now you tell me that which molecule first evaporate? Which molecule evaporate? Obviously the surface molecule, whatever the surface molecule evaporate first. Surface. Okay. So surface molecule gaakunda ikkada unna molecule evaporate aitunda direct ga? No. First this molecule will come to the surface. ఈ సర్ఫేస్కి వస్తుంది, ఇక్కడికి వచ్చిన తర్వాత ఇక్కడ నుంచి వెళ్ళి ఎస్కేప్ అవుతుంది. అంతేగాని డైరెక్ట్లీ ఇన్సైడ్ ఇన్నర్ మాలిక్యూల్ కెనాట్ వేపరైజ్. ఓన్లీ ద వేపరైజేషన్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ సర్ఫేస్ ఫినామినా. సర్ఫేస్ ఫినామినా. ఓకే. సో దీనికి కూడా మీరు ఏం చేయండి అంటే, యు టేక్ సమ్ వాటర్ ఇన్ టు ద వెరీ వైడ్ బౌల్ అండ్ యు టేక్ సమ్ వాటర్ ఇన్ టు ద వెరీ నారో బౌల్. అంటే సన్నగా ఉండే ఒక బౌల్ తీసుకోండి, వెడల్పు ఉన్న బౌల్ తీసుకోండి. అండ్ సింపుల్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్, వైల్ మేకింగ్ ఎ కర్రీ, యు నో హౌ టు మేక్ ఎ కర్రీ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ రైట్. అండ్ వైల్ మేకింగ్ ఎ కర్రీ, వెన్ యూ టేక్ ఎ స్మాల్ బౌల్, ఎ నారో బౌల్, మీరు వండుతున్నప్పుడు పెద్ద బౌల్లో కర్రీ వండినప్పుడు అందులో ఉన్న వాటర్ ఏమవుతుంది? ఈజీగా ఎవాపరేట్ అయిపోతుంది. ఈజీగా ఎవాపరేట్ అవుతుంది అండ్ ఈ ఆ కర్రీ ఏమవుతుంది, ఇట్ విల్ బికమ్ ఈజీలీ డ్రై అయిపోతుంది. ఓకే. అలా కాకుండా వెన్ యూ టేక్ ఇన్ టు ద నారో బౌల్ విత్ ద నారో లిడ్ ఉన్న బౌల్ తీసుకోండి. అప్పుడు వెన్ యూ డూ దట్ కర్రీ సేమ్, వెన్ యూ ప్రిపేర్ ద సేమ్ కర్రీ ఇన్ ద నారో బౌల్, అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది? ఇట్ కెనాట్ వేపరైజ్ దట్ మచ్ బికాస్ సర్ఫేస్ ఏదైతే ఉందో, మీరు ఇచ్చే సర్ఫేస్ ఉంది కదా. ఓకే. So you are taking a bowl like this, a narrow bowl, and there is a wide bowl. Okay. And in both the cases you are making the curry, but here you see here the surface, here it is a very, very high, here the surface is very, very small. Okay. The area, surface area. So that when you prepare in this the curry, in the short time the water, whatever that water present in it, it can easily evaporate. But here the surface area is less, so that here it can also evaporate, but it takes some time. So that means the evaporation is nothing but a surface phenomena. If the surface is high, then the evaporation is high. If the surface is less, the evaporation is less. Why? Because mostly the surface molecules evaporate first than the inner molecules. Okay. So that means the Vaporization, the vaporization or vapor pressure before going to the vapor, generally the liquid molecules will come from down to the surface, and from the surface it can evaporate. From the surface it can evaporate. Okay, so that means it depends on the surface molecules. The vaporization depends on the surface molecule. Surface molecule. Okay, yeah. Now you see here, before addition of the solute, you see that all the surface is occupied with the only the solvent molecules, only with the solvent molecules. Okay, so you assume that here how many are there? 7 solvent molecules are there. Okay, but after addition of solute molecules, how many solvent molecules are there? Only 1, 2, 3, 4, and remaining 3 are the solute. Endukante meeru solute ni add chestunnaru kada. So here, how many solute particles are there? Solvent particles are there on the surface. It has only 1, 2, 3, 4 solvent particles are there. Okay. And how many solute? Obviously, you are adding the solute means some solute particles can also take the surface. Can also take the surface. Okay. So here, you assume that 3 solute particles are also taking the surface. Okay, now here you see that earlier there are 7 solute particles are there on the surface, but now here you have only 4 solute particles on the surface. Okay, so that means the area occupied by the solvent molecules, the area occupied by the solvent molecules is decreasing. So once the area decreases, obviously the vaporization also decreases. Okay. So vaporization decreases, the vapor decreases. Vapor decreases means obviously vapor pressure also can be decreases. The vapor pressure also can be decreases. Okay. So only the thing how they are decreasing is that very simple. The solute particles are taking the surface of the solution, taking the positions in the surface of the solution, so that the volume or the area occupied by the solvent molecules is decreasing, so that the vaporization is decreasing. Okay, so that the vapor pressure also decreasing. Okay, so I am reading here, you look at here, in a pure liquid the entire surface is occupied by the molecules of liquid solvent only. Okay, but in the solution the surface has both solute and solvent molecules, and when non-volatile solute added to the solvent, the fraction of the surface covered by the solvent molecules get reduced. Okay, indaka em cheppanu, the solvent molecules surface anedi decrease aipothundi. Okay, so that the number of solvent molecule escaping from the surface is correspondingly less, so that the vapor pressure is also less, so that the vapor pressure is also less. Okay, so this is the thing why the vapor pressure decreases when the solid added to the liquid, when the solid added to the solvent. Okay, right. Okay, but now the question is that does it depend upon the solid? Okay, that means solid add chesthe vapor pressure decrease avutundi ani cheppanu. And now the other case, a solid add chesina ante decrease avutunda ledu, it will vary with the solid to solid. Does it vary with the solid to solid? Ante suppose na daggara 3 things unnai, okati glucose, urea, of course sugar, ee 3 unnai, these 3 are the solute. Okay, now what I will do is that I'll take some water, the water is a solvent. Okay, and now you know that when you added the solute to this water, the vapor pressure decreases. Okay, and in both the cases I'll take the same 1 mole 1 mole and one mole. Okay, so three cases lo same tiskuntanu. Okay, now the question is that when you added the glucose, urea and sugar, okay, meer add chesinappudu, does that decrease in the vapor pressure is same or not? అంటే మీరు సపరేట్ సపరేట్గా యాడ్ చేసినప్పుడు డిక్రీజ్ అవుతుందని చెప్పాను, మరి దాట్ డిక్రీజ్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ సేమ్ ఫర్ గ్లూకోజ్ యూరియా అండ్ షుగర్ ఆర్ ఈజ్ ఇట్ డిఫరెంట్? ఈజ్ దాట్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ సేమ్, ద డిక్రీజ్ ఇన్ వేపర్ ప్రెషర్ ఈజ్ సేమ్. ఓకే, సో దీస్ డిక్రీజ్ ఇన్ వేపర్ ప్రెషర్ డిపెండ్స్ ఓన్లీ on the number of molecules, number of molecules, and it does not depend on the, does not depend on the nature of the molecule, nature of the molecule. Okay, ante adi ela untundi, adi ఎసిడిక్ నేచరా, బేసిక్ నేచరా, పోలారా, నాన్ పోలారా, అవన్నీ మనకు అనవసరం. ఇట్స్ ఓన్లీ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ద నంబర్ ఆఫ్ మాలిక్యూల్స్, హౌ మెనీ నెంబర్, వన్ మోల్ అంటే అవగాడ్రో నెంబర్, వన్ మోల్ అవగాడ్రో నెంబర్, వన్ మోల్ అవగాడ్రో నెంబర్. ఓకే, ఇన్ బోత్ ద కేసెస్, ఇన్ ఆల్ ద కేసెస్ యు ఆర్ యాడింగ్ వన్ మోల్ మాలిక్యూల్స్, వన్ మోల్ మాలిక్యూల్స్, వన్ మోల్ మాలిక్యూల్స్. ఓకే, సో దట్ ద డిక్రీజ్ ఇన్ ద వేపర్ ప్రెషర్ ఈస్ సేమ్. ఓకే, రైట్, సో ఇట్ కెనాట్, it is, that is the reason what I am telling, it is only depends on the number of molecule, it is not going to be depend on the nature of the molecule, nature of the molecule. Okay, right, so here the decrease in the vapor pressure of water by adding 1 mole of sucrose to 1 kg of water is same as that produced by the adding 1 mole of urea to the same quantity of water at the same temperature, same temperature. Ante ikkade cheppan, indakane cheppan. So that decrease when you added the 1 mole of sucrose and 1 mole of urea, in both the cases it is same, the decrease in the vapor pressure, it cannot going to be vary. Okay, so that is the reason it is, so the, okay, so here you see this is the water and this is a mixture of sucrose and this is the urea, this is the urea when you added. Okay, so in both the cases, in both the cases, those are the binary solutions. Okay, and here the vapor pressure decreases, in both the cases vapor pressure decreases, and the decrease is same, the decrease is same, it is not going to be depend on the nature, it is not going to be depends on the nature. Okay, so see here the sentence is that the decrease in the vapor pressure of solvent depends on the quantity of the non-volatile solute present in the solution. Quantity means number, how many molecules, irrespective of its nature, irrespective of its nature. Okay, so that is the example. Okay, and now you see here, in a binary solution, consider solvent is solvent by 1 and non-volatile solute by 2. Okay, so here you know that only the solvent molecules are present in the vapor, only solvent molecules can be present in the vapor, because only the solvent molecules can be vaporized and gives the vapor pressure. Okay, and solute is obviously a non-volatile, so that it cannot vaporize, it cannot vaporize, so that they don't have any vapor. Okay, so overall the vapor pressure depends only on the mole fraction of the solvent, mole fraction of the solvent. Okay, so that P1 is equal to only P01 into X1, P01 into X1. Okay, P01 is nothing but vapor pressure of the pure solvent and X1 is the mole fraction of the solvent. Okay, now when you plot it according to the Raoult's law, you know that the mole fraction of solvent 0 to 1, so that the vapor pressure increases, the vapor pressure increases. Here you can say that it is nothing but a P01. Okay, so here the solution vapor pressure is nothing but a solvent vapor pressure, solution vapor pressure is nothing but solvent vapor pressure, because only the solvent can vaporize, the solute cannot be vaporized. Okay, but when you added this solid solute, the vapor pressure of the pure solvent decreases, solvent decreases because of the decrease in the surface molecules, surface molecules. Okay, right. So this is about the vapor pressure of the solids in liquids. Solids in liquids. Okay, and in the next lecture, we are going to see about the colligative properties. Colligative properties. Okay, what are the colligative properties and how many types are there? That we can discuss in the next lecture. Okay, okay. So before going to that, we will also see some problems based on the Henry's law, Raoult's law, and this vapor pressure of the solids in liquids. Okay.